What's up, guys? Today's junk is the Billy Goat lawn vac that I made a video about last week. I made a simple and inexpensive modification that should make my life a little easier. Long story short, the Billy Goat lawn vac has an option for a hose to be used instead of the nozzle that's on the ground. So the hose allows you to get into the flower beds and other hard to reach areas. And the hose, I think, is around 7 feet long. So I could be wrong about that, but that's what it seems like. It has a handle on the end and everything, and I'll show you what it looks like soon. But there is a plate on the front of the actual device, the machine, that you have to unscrew and remove, and then you install the nozzle, and it's kind of cumbersome. And it actually adds a few minutes to the job. So I was trying to think of a quick way where I can leave the hose installed permanently, but have some sort of valve or what have you that I can open and close when I need to use the nozzle versus the hose itself. So I came up with the idea of using a blast gate that you would use for dust collection systems. It's the same size hose, it's a 4-inch hose, and I got a couple other odds and ends to make this work. So I'm going to put a link to all the parts down below that I got from Amazon, and altogether it was less than $40. So there's a flange, there's hose clamps, there's you'll see, I'll point everything out. But I'm going to take you outside and show you the actual machine. Once again, it's loaded up on the trailer, and I'm going to pull out the hose and show you what it looks like. But if I get the opportunity, because I got to get this video edited and uploaded, if I get the opportunity before I need to upload this video, I will get some footage of this thing in action too. Hopefully I can, and we'll put it all in one video. If not, the footage of this thing working will be in a later video. So let's take you outside and show you the machine. So here's the Billy Goat, and I have it on the trailer right now. So when I'm transporting it on the trailer, the way I store it, I am unable to have the hose installed because it actually comes out a little further than originally. So I just put this block of wood here and it keeps everything nice and safe. So anyway, this flange is the first thing I had to install. And all I did was use some self-tapping screws and epoxy. And the two-part epoxy really keeps that thing in place. It's not going anywhere. It's on there forever now. This flange is a 4-inch flange, and it's just made out of plastic. I'll put links all down below. Now, this would then be connected to this rubber piece here. And this is a coupler. It comes with the hose clamps and everything that you see here, and it slides right over. I tighten it down real good. It stays on place, no problem. I'm thinking about switching out this hose clamp for one that looks more like this, where it's got a thumb screw on there, and that will allow this to be a toolless removal. Next, I have this blast gate, and this blast gate is the same thing that you would use for dust collection. It's a aluminum, so it's going to be a little more weather resistant and stronger. And it's got this tension knob. So you open that, pull this open, and that will allow the hose to be used. I shut it, tighten this down, and now everything will be sucked through the nozzle as intended normally. And this hose goes all the way up here, down to this end here, and it has a handle. And that handle is extendable, so I can use this while standing at my normal height. No crouching or anything. And I just leave it sitting here until I'm ready to use it, and then I slip it on, tighten it up, you're good to go. Now, when I do need to use the nozzle, I need to install a plate down here, and that just slides on. And here's the plate. This just slides down underneath onto the bottom main nozzle, and that directs air to be sucked through the hose all the way into the back of the machine where it gets shredded. Originally, this piece was on the end of the hose that would be then slid into this area where the flange is. So picture the flange missing, and there's a plate that's normally covering the hole. You remove the plate, this part would be permanently installed on the hose itself, and then it gets slid in and twisted, because you got these screws that allow it to be slid in, and then you twist it to hold it in place. And you know, this I'm thinking about using to actually rig up a extension where I can clean gutters using the Billy Goat. I need a long enough hose to do that, but get up on a ladder, put the hose in the gutter, suck everything out, makes the job nice and easy. I don't know if that's a pipe dream or not, but no pun intended there. But I guess that is something I could use this machine for as well. We'll see. So that's that. This is the modification I made on the billy goat to make my life a little easier during leaf collection season, which is now. So leaves are already falling, and I'm starting to get some jobs lined up. And my current customers are asking me to remove their leaves. So this billy goat will be indispensable for this season. Well, if you guys like this video, please click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And as always, I can be found on Twitter and Instagram at Gettin' Junk Done. Thanks for watching.